Hi there! In this video, we will be talking about how to write an if-then hypothesis. Before writing your if-then hypothesis statement, it is important to begin with a research question. The research question is a question that you have identified as being something that you are interested in studying, something that impacts the reader and society, and usually something that has not been thoroughly researched. You can start by identifying a problem, then create a research question that can be tested. For example, if I was curious about the effects of coffee on mood, in particular anxiety, I might ask, does consuming coffee increase anxiety? Be sure to ask a question that is testable. In other words, you should be able to gather information or data in an experiment that can be analyzed in order to answer your research question. For our research question, an example of an experimental design could be collecting data from participants that are willing to be in a study where they drink coffee and complete surveys that measure anxiety. The next step is to conduct some background research on the research question. This is where you can utilize the Purdue University Global Library and other scientific databases to find reliable scientific journal articles that have information on the topic in your field. While conducting your research, note if your research question has been previously researched thoroughly or if there is room for more research. Ask yourself the following questions. Has this research question been thoroughly researched by independent research groups? Do the results of the studies report the same findings? If there are conflicting results, can this present study contribute more to the field? Also remember that while you are reading more on your research question, you should be collecting background information on the topic in order to present it to the reader. This will give the reader more background on the field and the objective of the study. You will also be gathering information for the introduction and discussion of your paper. Lastly, you should be collecting research ideas and key findings that might influence your hypothesis, experiment, and overall study. The last step is to take the information from your background research and your research questions and make an educated guess as to what the answer will be to your research question. Note that the hypothesis is a statement and is not written in a question format. When writing a hypothesis, you can use the if-then format. However, it is not required unless specifically stated in your assignment's instructions. An example of an if-then hypothesis is, if one consumes 3 or more cups of coffee, then the participant's anxiety scores will be higher than normal. This also gives the reader what is being measured in the study, also known as the dependent variable. In this example, what is being measured is the anxiety score. The reader can also see the variable that is being studied or manipulated, also known as the independent variable. In this example, the number of cups of coffee is being measured to see what the effect is on the participant's level of anxiety. Take note that the hypothesis is an educated guess. This means that after conducting research on the topic and reviewing information from reliable sources, you will take a stance and answer your research question. For example, if you conduct research and found that consumption of coffee correlated with higher levels of anxiety due to the increased amount of caffeine, then your hypothesis can reflect that knowledge or information. This is why it is important to conduct some background research. To summarize, when writing a hypothesis, you will ask a research question or identify a problem that you would like to try to solve. Next, you will conduct some background research on your research question and your topic of interest to see what other researchers have done and to collect more information on the topic. Based on the information from your research and your research question, you will make a statement that can be written in the if-then format and makes an educated guess to your research question. Thank you for watching!